Assalamu alaikum. In this video, today we will talk about the photochemistry of the vision. For that, we must discuss the rhodopsin retinal visual cycle. What is that one? It is a subvisual cycle in which the decomposition of rhodopsin, which is the photochemical substance present in the rods, that is going to be decomposed and change into retinal. The cis form is going to be changed into trans form. How this happens? The details are shown here. In the presence of light, when sunlight falls over the rods, rhodopsin is going to be changed into other form, that is from the cis retinol into the all trans retinol. How this process takes place? When light rays falls over this substance, it is at once decomposed into its intermediate products with the opsin and cis retinol. The intermediate products, they include bartho, then lumirhodopsin, then metarhodopsin 1, metarhodopsin 2, and finally into opsin and cis retinol under the effect of isomerase enzyme. One more thing you must add here, that in the presence of vitamin A, the all trans retinol can change into all trans retinol. The vitamin A is abundant in the pigment layer as well as in the rods also. This reaction takes place in the darkness when this cis retinol combines with the opsin and there is reformation of the rhodopsin. So in the light, the decomposition takes place, while in the darkness, the synthesis of more and more rhodopsin takes place. Its further detail we can have, but before that you must check this one also. It is a very simple diagram to show just the conversion of or decomposition of the rhodopsin and conversion of cis form into all trans form without showing the intermediate products. The cycle starts when the light rays falls over the rhodopsin and it decomposes into opsin and all trans retinol. And in the presence of vitamin A, it changes into retinol, all trans retinol, and then with the combination of opsin, the rhodopsin again form in the darkness. This reaction takes place in rods. So the first step is reconvert to cis form of retinol. It requires energy and is catalyzed by retinal isomerase. Once formed, it binds to the protein and is stable. Second pathway converts the trans retinol to trans retinol in the presence of vitamin A. So the trans retinol is then converted into cis retinol. Vitamin A is, as I have told you already, that it is not only present in the pigment layer but also abundant in the cytoplasm of the rods. Excess retinol is converted to vitamin A. So it is also on one side there is conversion of retinol to the retinol, but also excess is converted into vitamin A. And this is the reason that Vitamin A is necessary for the vision, especially at night in the darkness. The abundant source of the vitamin A is carrot, and from that is the reason that to improve the vision, you must eat more and more carrots. Excitation of rod when rhodopsin is activated by light, how that take place. Now we will discuss the electrical changes occurring in the rod. Previously I have told all the changes regarding the chemical changes, that is what chemical substance is decomposed, what are the intermediate products, and what will be the final product, and how the resynthesis of rhodopsin take place. These are all included in the chemical changes, but what is the electrical change occur in the rod? That is, the rod receptor potential is hyperpolarized, not the depolarized. When rhodopsin decomposes, it decreases the rod membrane conductance for sodium ions in the outer segment of the rod, and this causes the hyperpolarization of the entire rod membrane. Now, from this figure, I can explain all these things. As we know that this is the inner segment and outer segment. Regarding the electrical changes, these two segments, they are behaving almost opposite to each other, or you can say they are behaving in different way, and not only different from each other, but also they behave differently in light and in darkness. This segment, that is the inner segment, here the continuously sodium potassium pump is working, because of which continuously sodium is going out while the potassium is going inside. In the inner segment, potassium is moved outside, while this outer segment, that behaves in a very different manner. You can see the red color of the sodium ions, they are either entering into the outer segment or not entering. Once this active pump is there, because of that the sodium is continuously coming out and potassium is coming inside. They both are balancing each other. Okay, but on the other side, the potassium comes out, so that from here the sodium is going out, from the other side potassium is going out. What is behind that is the excessive negativity, which must be checked, which must be balanced. Now this segment, it behaves in a very different way. It has the sodium channels which are guided with cyclic GMP. In the darkness, these channels, they open so that the sodium can come inside and can balance the loss of potassium from the inner side, inner segment. But in the light, the opposite effect takes place. I will tell you later on what is the reason, how that takes place, but you must know here that the sodium channels in the light, they are closed. They are not allowing the sodium to come inside, so that the remaining is excessive negativity. In the darkness, it is going to balance the potassium loss, but in the light, as they are closed, so there is excessive negativity inside the rod. In the other diagram, you can see the behavior is changed here in the darkness and in the light. It is only the picture of the outer segment. because inner segment is behaving same as for the light for the darkness. But the change occur here in the outer segment, it behaves in a different way in the light and in different way in the darkness. So in the darkness, the sodium, you can see they are coming inside as the channels they are open, while in the darkness the channels they are closed and sodium cannot come inside. If we go further in detail, then we recognize that in the light, when the light falls on this substance, chemical substance, what happens? Activation of the protein transduction that take place, which is activating this enzyme, and so that the more and more cyclic GMP is converted into 5-GMP. That is, its strength, its quantity is continuously decreasing in the light. So the channels, they are closed. Because for the opening of these channels, which are cyclic GMP gated sodium channels, actually they need excessive strength, excessive amount of cyclic GMP. If through any source the strength or the quantity of cyclic GMP decreases, they are closed. So this is the process through which its quantity decreases, which leads to the closure of the sodium channels. But in the darkness, the opposite effect takes place, and there will be opening in the, as we have the abundant cyclic GMP, no light, this process cannot be initiated in the darkness. So the excessive cyclic GMP remains there and lead to the opening of the sodium channels to allow more and more sodium inside to balance the excessive loss of potassium. So what happens? This is another animation showing the active process of sodium potassium pump here and the entrance of the sodium through the cyclic GMP gated sodium channels. And here you can see the substance that is changed and under the effect of sunlight. So this is one more animation to explain all the process. One more thing I want to tell you about this thing, that is one, that here when the sodium pump is actively participating in this process, and here the potassium is going out, changing the permeability and changing the potential, so that the polarized state is there. But here when there is no entry of the sodium, it leads to the excessive negativity, so that there will be hyperpolarization. In the darkness, when they enter inside the outer segment, they balance the potassium loss so that they are decreasing the internal negativity. All these changes they are included in the electrical changes regarding the photochemical cycle, visual cycle, which is occurring in the rods. So when there is less negativity, we can have the potential around -40. But in other case, when the negativity increases, it can lead to the hyperpolarization and the potential becomes -70. So if you are asked about the photochemical changes regarding the vision, you have to explain not only the chemical change but also the electrical change. Chemical change, that is including that how the rhodopsin is going to be decomposed and cis is converted into all in the form, and then in the darkness the all form is converted into cis form, so that having the intermediate substances also. And regarding the electrical changes, we can have the polarized state with the hyperpolarization. As in other case, the negativity increases as compared to the reverse condition. So we can have the hyperpolarized state. This I have already explained all these things. Now the next topic, that is the photochemistry of the color vision by the cones. Basically, the cones, they are meant for the color vision and also the white light, as it is the combination of different colors. So with the combination of different colors, you can perceive the white light or any other shade of the light. So basically these are the cones which are responsible for the color vision and also the white light. And rods, they are more actively participating in the darkness when you want to visualize anything in the darkness. So, and other thing, how you, different among both of these, that cones, they are mostly present in the central part, abundantly present at macula, while as you go towards the periphery of the retina, the number of the cones that decreases, but the rods, they are maximum at the periphery. So the photochemistry of color vision by the cones, only one of three types of color pigment is present in each of the different cones. To have the color vision, which is the main function of the cone, we have basically three types of the cones, or we can say there are three basic colors: blue, green and red. From these three colors, which are the basic color, you can have abundant 100,000 combinations, different shades and different colors, and all the colors, they are originated with the combination of these three basic colors. You can have the example of alphabets. You can have the alphabets from A to Z. And can you imagine how many English words you can form from these words, from alphabets from A to Z? This is the same example here, that basically we have the three types of the colors which are present in different three types of the cones: blue, green and red. And with the combination of these three colors, you can have countless color combinations. This is the wavelength range of these colors. That blue cone that starts from here going beyond the 500. Then we can have the green cone and red cone showing their wavelengths. What happens with the combination of different colors? You can have the combination of these two, or you can have these two, or the different shades, so that you can have 100 or countless combinations and the end result of the countless colors. And this in the center, you can have the rods as you are visualizing here. So all the colors present in the world, they are the combination of these three basic colors. Now coming to the light adaptation and dark adaptation, I will discuss the color vision in more detail later on with its abnormalities. But here I must tell you the light adaptation and dark adaptation. If a person has been in the bright light for hours, large portion of the photochemical substance in both the rods and the cones will have been reduced to retinol and opsin. Decomposition take place. Okay. Furthermore, much of the retinol of both the rods and the cones will have been converted into vitamin A also. Because of these two effects, the concentration of the photosensitive chemical remaining in the rods and cones are considerably becoming less and less, and the sensitivity of the eye to the light is correspondingly, obviously, it also decreases. This is called the light adaptation. As you have your own experience, if you spend a lot of time in the sunlight and then go to the dark room, you will take some time to visualize the things clearly after you are able to visualize these things. And same thing happen if you stay in the darkness for longer time and you come in the sunlight, you will take some time for your adjustment of the vision. This is the same thing. This is the adjustment of the vision in the eye, same to the accommodation process. When you visualize far object and after that you visualize the near object, your eye is going to adjust all these changes. In the same way, if we consider the photochemical substances, so the effect of darkness and the light, that is, if you have spend more time in the light then come to the darkness, your eye is going to adjust all these things to have a clear image formation. It will take some time, and the same effect will happen when you stay at in a dark room and come to the light. These changes through which the eye is going to adjust itself, that is called the light adaptation and dark adaptation. In the accommodation, we have many changes regarding the surface of the lens, its AP diameter and all these things, and also the pupillary size. Same in the light and dark adaptation, we can have the change of the pupillary size, and also with that the neural circuits, they are also taking part in this change. So these changes occur, and collectively you can have the light adaptation and dark adaptation, and through this process you are able to visualize the things clearly in the darkness and also in the light. But it needs some time. Adaptation is at once, but light and dark, accommodation is at the same time, at once. But light and dark adaptation, as during that process, some chemical change that is occurring, because of that, you need some time to adjust your vision. This is the minutes in the darkness. When you stay more and more time in the darkness, the rods, they are becoming fully functional. Yes, they are more functional in the darkness as compared to the cones, which are more active in the light. So I have told you, for the light and dark adaptation, two things, they are very much important. Number one thing, the pupillary size, and secondly, the neuronal adaptation. The change in the pupillary size, you have all experienced yourself, that in the light it decreases, so that a limited strength, a limited intensity of light rays should fall over the retina. Otherwise, they will going to damage. If the pupillary size that remains fixed, there is no change, it is going to damage the retina. In the darkness, as the light rays, they are very much less in strength, less in quantity, so द पीपल इज डायलेटेड, सो मतलब मोर एंड मोर वेव्स दे कैन एंटर इन टू द आई एंड स्ट्राइक ओवर द रेटिना टू हैव अ वेल इमेज. सो इट इज द एडजस्टमेंट ऑफ द पुपुलरी साइज थ्रू विच यू कैन हैव द लाइट एंड डार्क एडेप्टेशन. एंड सेकेंड फैक्टर दैट इज द न्यूरोनल एडेप्टेशन. सम ऑफ द सेल्स, न्यूरोनल सेल्स विच विल डिस्कस इन नेक्स्ट वीडियो, लाइक बाइपोलर, हॉरिजोंटल, दीज सेल्स दे आर ऑल्सो वेरी मच एक्टिव रिगार्डिंग द लाइट एंड डार्क एडेप्टेशन. इफ they are if the intense light enter they also become intense, but their effect soon decreases. And other factors included take part in this process, but you must remember that they are also behaving in a different way in the light and in the dark. And this I have discussed that with the combination of different wavelengths, you can have intermediate colors. And what is the maximum? That is the for the blue, this is the maximum. And for the green and like that, the spectral sensitivity of three types of the cones are shown here. Now, coming to the abnormalities, for that you can have, this is the normal process, that with the combination of different colors you can have the white color. That's it's shown here, and this is the combination to which you can have different color perception. Again, normal color vision, and with this red-green color vision deficiency, if now we are going to discuss the abnormalities named as color blindness. The most important thing about that is I must tell you that this word includes, that is the color blindness, means that the person cannot perceive any type of the color. But actually, the color blindness, we use this word, but we are going to have the meaning that is some of the color they are not perceived as such, but others they are perceived. So actually these patients, they are perceiving colors. Some of the colors they are perceived in 100% correct manner, while the sum of the colors they cannot be perceived as such. So actually these patients, they are not color blind. They can perceive the colors, but in a different manner. What are these? Basically, you can see the one more animation to show the how the effect of the white light and also the dark splitting of the dark light. You can have this one. What you should see is the colors of the pencil fade out. If you don't see any change over a period of 5 to 10 seconds, you might want to pop down to your local ophthalmologist, especially as 40% of the pupil currently leaving secondary school and are unaware they have vision or color deficiencies. Many of the students, they don't know that they are colorblind because they have never seen the actual colors. When you check the color vision, then they are able to recognize that they have deficiency of some of the perception of the sum of particular colors. Otherwise, as by birth they are not visualizing these colors, so they always see the same combination. They never recognize their this deficiency. So when you check their color vision, only then they come to know that they cannot perceive some of the selected colors. To check the color vision, you have your separate practical in the lab, but here I must tell you something about the abnormalities. This is the normal thing, that is the blue, green and red color, but you can have, this is the man, he is going to check the color vision in this animation. Types of the color blindness. This is the thing you must know. The first thing, that is the normal color vision, is called the trichromacy. We can have its abnormalities also. In some, the red-green color blindness is there. In some, the red light is not perceived. Some cannot have the green light perception. So accordingly we can have these abnormalities. You can see from here, in which some of the specific color they cannot be perceived. So this is the reason that these patients or these person, they can perceive some of the colors and its combinations, but some of the combination cannot be perceived. Monochromacy is the condition in which no color at all is perceived, and this is just like as you can have the black and white television without color. We can have the color TV and we can have the black and white TV like that. If the person is not perceiving any type of the color, we will label as monochromacy, and in this they cannot perceive any type of the color. This is the best picture to show all the abnormalities here with the normal inside here. These are the protanopia, deuteropia, trinopia and monochromatism. So with that, you must recognize the abnormalities of the color vision. These are some more specific and detailed points according to the each abnormality. If you are interested, you can read these also, that black with the many shades of the red, they are deficient here. Dark brown, this is specifically mentioning the combinations. If there is deficiency of one type of the cone, for example blue, the blue color with all its combinations cannot be perceived clearly. So this is the thing about that deuteropes are more likely to confuse mid reds with the mid greens, blue greens with the gray and mid pinks like that. Tritonopes, they are the most common color confusions of tritonopes, are light blues with gray, dark purple with black, mid green with blue and oranges with red. So this is all about the photochemistry of the vision, plus the light and dark adaptation, and also the color vision. About the color vision, you have your practical in the lab also. So with that, we complete this topic. Thank you and Allah Hafiz.